Welcome to Yellow Brick Road. I'm Jordan, and today I'm going to make sure my microphone is working. Yes! Today, as you can see, Joe Biden picks Kamala Harris as his running mate, his VP pick. But first, please consider donating to Devin's Journey to Recovery. The GoFundMe link is in the description box. If you got $5 or more laying around and you want to donate to a charity, you can. Helping out one of our subscribers and his wife, you can donate at Devin's Journey to Recovery. The GoFundMe link is in the description box. All right. So, yeah, Joe Biden selects Kamala Harris to be his vice presidential running mate. Now, if you're watching this channel, if you've watched multiple videos of mine, you already know that, like, not surprised, creepy, corrupt, Joe Biden's going to pick someone else who is creepy and corrupt in case he croaks if he wins the presidency. So Kamala Harris fits right in there, right? That's like their aim is to go after a demographic, right? For people who are still disillusioned and think Kamala Harris is some sort of freedom fighter for them. Meanwhile, we all know about her stint as Attorney General in California, right? And the forced prison labor, moms getting in trouble for their kids not getting to school. Meanwhile, not introducing any policy to help moms out, really. And we know about all this shit already with Kamala Harris. And we remember Tulsi Gabbard scorching her. And then TYT trying to take credit away from Tulsi Gabbard for that. But, all right, we know about this. My opinion on this, just in the realm of winning, right? Just in the realm of Joe Biden trying to win the presidency. I don't think this helps him too much. And it's already shown that he has the older black vote. This might gather some younger black people, but not enough. Not enough. We saw her in the polls drop off once Tulsi Gabbard scorched her on her criminal justice record. Right? It's like those numbers fell way off. So it's like, oh, that means a whole lot of people know about all this shit now. You've been exposed. So this isn't helping Joe Biden. I don't think it's helping him too much. He already had the older black vote. And as far as that large slice of people, right? People are forgetting, like, Bernie Sanders, wasn't he breaking, like, campaign donation records? Wasn't he doing that? I can't see those people voting for Biden and Harris. Don't fucking see it. Unless, the majority reports, the TYTs, the whoever's tricked their audience and they're like, well, it's better than Trump. I mean, Trump is the end of the world. Biden is almost the end of the world, but he's not quite there. If he wins, he can at least scave off, the apocalypse until we can get our right person in there. AOC, the right person, the right grifter. But, yeah, I don't see this helping him too much. At least, from what things I'm seeing and what I'm hearing, I don't think it helps him too much. Now let's get into the more important topic to me, which I've said multiple times before, and I'm going to say it again. It's turning back the clock on, you know, the social political dynamic that's happening now. I'm about to sneeze. All right, I held it back. The social political, you know, dynamic, you know, environment we're in right now, they're trying to put an end to that. You see, docile people are, it's a lot easier to just do whatever you want in a world like that. In a world where people just put their heads down, keep quiet, go to work, feed the kids, go to sleep, wake up, repeat it over and over. They want that. They want that. They just want you to lift, not even lift your head all the way up, just lift your eyelids up every 4 years and vote for whoever's personality we make you think is the best personality. Or if you want to feel like you're countercultural, they'll make the other team will make their side look like, oh, this is against the grain here. Meanwhile, it's just George Bush. Like Donald Trump, right? It's just George Bush. But you've been tricked into thinking, like, oh, this is a rebel, because look how he's talking. So, yeah, the whole point of all this, I believe, this is my conspiracy theory, is to turn the take all the bottled up anxiety and curiosity, right? People searching through the internet for information and shit. Take all of that and turn it into the old style of politics where we vote for George Bush and Bill Clinton policies, right? And you might as well make George Bush and Bill Clinton the same too. They're just continuations of each other with different looking, different stylized version. Now, the faces are going to change, right? You're going to have different colors of people, different, I don't know, sexual orientation, different this, different that, all on the surface things. But the policy is going to be a one continuous track. That's the goal here in my conspiracy theory. And but you know they found a little bump in the road, and that was, you know, mostly the youth, with obviously older people who have been fighting against this shit their whole lives. It's like there's a lot more of those people today than there were in the past, and that can become a major roadblock. So you got to get rid of them somehow. Now, my conspiracy theory doesn't include just fucking mowing people down and killing them or whatever. My conspiracy theory is basically what I've just been saying. Compromise the heads, your favorite people, all the people the youth listen to, and turn them into the old school politics. You know, once again, the mask could be different, like TYT. We're like, we're against the grain and no corporate bailouts, or what did I say? No money in politics. And then that same year, they'll tell you to vote for Joe Biden. Right? Cenk Uygur will explain all the corruption of his opponent and then tell you to vote for her because she's better than the other guy. Right? The means are different. It isn't, you know, full-scale corporate Democratic talking points that are getting you to vote for the corporate Democrat, but it's still the end result is still them telling you to vote for the corporate Democrat or the corporate Republican, which I guess would be Donald Trump in this instance. And yeah, once again, I have to add this fucker in there, that Tim Pool guy, man. I keep saying it because I don't see the bigger YouTubers talking about this fucking guy. Right? You look at him, and you look at the way he used to look and all that shit, and it's like, huh, who's this, you know, I guess hipster punk rock skateboarding, indie, you know, independent beanie wearing journalist guy, right? There's an image there. Right? That's why he got hired by Vice, because he has an image to him. But the substance is, my statues! I like statues. They're taking down statues. Our founding fathers did not fight to have us, you know, succumb to these far leftists. It's like, That's the narrative. Different window dressing, right? He's the skater looking, punk rock looking dude, right? Or a hipster, indie hipster looking dude who's crying about AOC and the far left and Antifa and all that shit. The mask is different, but what does he get you to do? Oh, just vote for Donald Trump, who we understand now is just a traditional George Bush Republican. Even Trump himself. WikiLeaks and drain the swamp and all that shit, right? All of it led to just the result that's wanted by these creepers, which is, oh, this is just typical. This is the same shit that's been happening for decades, centuries even. Same exact shit. Like, what did he do today? He sent, like, what, 5,000 Mark Esper, his Secretary of Defense, or whatever the fuck he does, 5,000 more troops into Afghanistan? Yeah. Drain the fucking swamp, man.
Trust the plan. Trust it.
So, what should be done about this game being played? I guess that's the big thing. Well, first thing you got to do is break down your own conditioning, right? If you're still latched on to what, you know, most people break away from this, but there's still people there that are still latched on to, like, what does mommy and daddy think, right? Straight up, like, blood-related mom and dad. Then it goes a little level further. Like, what's mommy and daddy think? But this time, mommy and daddy are whatever social figures that people become infatuated with. I'm not saying these are all the worst things ever. I'm just saying it's a part of a conditioning that I see happening. You know, a lot of people latch on the politicians as mommy and daddy, or even the country itself as mommy and daddy. So, you know, it could be a TV character. It could be anything. Like, what is moving people to choose these guys? Even if it's a lesser of two evils argument, it's still a form of conditioning, right? It's like, oh, based on material assessments, I believe that this will be the better case. Say, okay. But how will corruption leave if you're literally giving room for corruption? In your mind, it may be less corruption, but it's still corruption, is it not? So, conditioning. Number one thing you gotta deal with yourself and with other people. Right? You gotta deal with their condition. What type of psychological baggage is someone bringing to you when you're telling them that Joe Biden is a creeper, and they're like, "No, he was vice president. You can't make it to the level of vice president if you're like that much of a bad person." Right? You got to be able to break down their conditioning. Another thing, a strict rule of strict rules of principles for yourself as an individual. Right? This isn't even going into is morality objective or subjective. Let's just call it subjective. You work on yourself. What are your principles? What are the lines that cannot be crossed by anyone? Right? Stick with them and apply them to these people. Then apply them to the people around you. When someone comes in quiet, it's like, do you know what Trump's going to do? How could you not vote for Biden? Yeah, Biden's not the greatest guy ever, but he's a lesser of two evils. It's like, has Biden played a large role in killing anyone? Yeah, then he's done. That's it. Fuck that guy. Should never even be anywhere near this. So have like a strict code. Become Batman. Have a code that you follow. I mean, really, like, seriously, make that a real thing where it's like, these lines never get crossed, period. if someone's trying their best to make it gray, like, fuck that shit. Black and white here. Like, killing is wrong no matter what. I don't need a... Yeah, but what if he's attacking you with a knife? No, it's wrong. Stop it. If you can't handle that shit, go somewhere else. That's me, though. You should come up with your own. Yeah. Once again, my conspiracy, that's the big game. To take this bottled up anxiety that's starting to express itself and turn it over to a salesman in a nice suit who smiles when he looks at you. He always looks you in the eye. He has a firm handshake. That means he's a good person. Trust him. Meanwhile, they sell you a car with no brakes. Actually, no, it's probably the other way around. They sell you a really, really nice car, so you forget you even met this person. It's like, they're not worried about me, they're worried about the car. Make sure the car is running nice and smoothly, so they don't look up any at any point. They keep their head down and just drive. Don't pay attention to what's going on outside your windows. I got good mileage on this car. I don't want to give it up. Come on, man. Come on, the guy gave me a nice handshake. You can't be a bad person. I know these things. You gotta look a man in the eye. And you'll know. Meanwhile, they don't know shit. Alright. Anything else I can add to this? I mean, that's the biggest thing to me. Is watching the... Watching... the cheese at the end of the maze that the mice are looking for, and just watching fuckers like these, like Kamala Harris or Joe Biden or Donald Trump, watching them turn walls and shit to force you towards a direction. I mean, yeah, I'm just watching it happen. Yeah, hopefully someone sees this. Hopefully someone with a platform will say, hey, what's going on out here? Say, hey, I'm Jimmy Dore. I don't need to be an apologist for TYT. Right? Notice how Jimmy can't defend the content. Only thing he can defend is the character he made up in his mind. But Cenk's a good guy. So that means that when the Russiagate stuff happens or the Tulsi smearing happens, it's because he honestly, truly believes that. There's nothing nefarious happening. Yeah. see what you can do when you just get a little thread? You can just fucking turn it into a whole thing. Yeah. All right. That's it for me. I mean, I don't know. I hit record and I just talk shit. Look at that. Might even be right about a couple things. Who knows? Alright, that's it for me. Please subscribe if you feel like. Comment. Agree. Disagree. What do you think? Is Kamala is she the best pick for winning? Alright, let me put it this way. Alright, as far as just winning, whether you like Joe Biden or not, is Kamala Harris the right pick to help him win? That's one question. Two, what do you think about Kamala Harris? Like, with all your add all your biases in there, what do you think about Kamala Harris being his running mate? I'm pretty sure what people are going to be saying. They're going to crap on her and him. And then, I guess, last thing, what do you think about my conspiracy theory? I've brought it up multiple videos, so I guess I'll just ask again. What do you think about my conspiracy theory? Are they trying to turn the clock back, in a way, to get people who are screaming, freedom, and get them into saying, jobs, the economy, revolution? Lower taxes. For fuck's sake, man. Ugh. right. Don't forget to donate. Devin's Journey to Recovery, GoFundMe link in the description box. And with all that said, give this video a thumbs down. Say you wanna get him.